Okay, so this is the procedure for the replacement of the oil seal in the housing cap. Okay, so the cap has been removed already. Okay. And I already removed the old seal that was previously inside. So it was a very tricky job because it has been sitting here for a long time. So my advice would be, with the help of a screwdriver and the hammer, to remove it. And it will take some time, especially if it has never been replaced. And at the end, when the tour of the seal starts to be a bit damaged, you take the screwdriver, you put it inside, you apply a kind of lever to remove it, okay? So at the end, you just clean it inside. It looks like that. And you're ready for the replacement with a new one. Okay, this one. You just insert it inside. Okay, you put pressure on it. You can gently use the hammer, okay, with the protection. And be careful because if you go too hard, you risk to bend this little metal part here. Now, to install the cap in the gearbox, you have two options. There are some models with an O-ring that goes here, okay? Or you have some models like this one with a gasket. So this one has a gasket. I ordered a new one. So you put the gasket in the cap. And you just insert it on the propeller shaft. Here. Put the head of the water pump on the drive shaft. And here, this hole is where our little pin that is blocking the impeller goes. Okay? And you can reassemble the impeller in the drive shaft. So you can put some, maybe some grease, because if it is brand new, you will have maybe some trouble because it's very narrow. Okay, so you will have to put some efforts on it. So now that this is reinstalled, don't forget to turn it always clockwise. And when you are going to insert the drive shafts in the gearbox, you see that it will come here. And the trick here is, first of all, to put back the washer. And my advice would be to just turn it the other way around, put back it first the circle here, and secondly the washer, and then this part, okay, that transfer the movements of the drive shaft to the propeller shaft. Okay, this part goes here. And what is tricky here is to insert the drive shaft into this part, okay? Because you never know if it's well positioned or not, and it's really narrow, so it's gonna take time, okay? But at the end, it should work this way, okay? Next step is to screw the head of the water pump inside the lower unit, okay, on the lower unit, okay? So just apply it with the seal, okay, the metal seal here, and then simply put the two screws, one here and the other one here, okay, and you need to tighten them. So to reinstall the lower unit into the engine, just put some grease on the top of the drive shaft, okay, all around. And by the way, you also need to obviously install back this little piece of metal here and slide it inside, and the tube for the water needs to be also installed here in this rubber black part here, okay?